Welcome, everyone, to the USA Men's National Team from Manchester, England. Presented by Nike Plus. In a seasonably cool day in Manchester, just 59 degrees. As we approach tip-off, it's the third game for the USA's pre-Olympic tour tonight, taking on Great Britain after wins against the Dominican Republic and Brazil. Time now for our Prime to Perform, brought to you by Gatorade. And a spotlight look at LeBron James leading the way for the United States against Brazil a few nights ago in Washington, D.C. LeBron with a strong second half and ending up with 30 points to go along with six rebounds. LeBron James turned it up at both ends of the court in that game in Washington, D.C. against Brazil.
Well, what else is new? LeBron James, not only is he arguably maybe the best player in the world right now, but this will be his 52nd contest representing Team USA, another guy comfortable with FIBA basketball.
He was voted the most outstanding player of that game against Brazil in D.C. Here's a look at the numbers after two exhibition games. The number, friend, that really jumps off the page at you, the three-point shooting by both these guys.
Well, both of these guys, remember, the line is shorter in FIBA by a foot and a half. Very comfortable, almost a mid-range jumper for both of those tremendous players.
Both of them shooting well above 50% from the field as well. A lot of excitement in Great Britain as they head toward the Olympics for the first time in 64 years. Right now, across the way. And in the 2011 Eurobasket, averaged almost 25 points a game. He is the guy that Great Britain is going to hang their hat on. Time now for our Nike starting lineups. And Fran, a bit of a change in the USA starting lineup today, with Kevin Durant and Deron Williams in for Carmelo Anthony and Chris Paul.
Well, I talked to the coaching staff of Team USA yesterday. They said they feel they have seven starters. Durant and Williams go into the lineup. Let's see if that shakes things up as Coach K looking for that right combination.
Nate Greinke, Mike Linsley, Luol Deng, who we saw a few moments ago, Joel Freeland, who will be joining the Portland Trailblazers in a couple of months, and Pops Mensah-Bonsu, another NBA player that a lot of you might be familiar with, the starting five for Great Britain. And Mike Krzyzewski now 51-1 as USA Basketball Senior Men's National Team head coach. That lone loss coming back in 2006, his first year effectively on the job.
When you talk about Coach K, you're talking about a guy with four NCAA titles, heading towards 1,000 NCAA wins, and growing very comfortable as the coach of Team USA over the past six seasons. Argentina will be in their pool in the Olympics, Spain in the other pool. I don't expect them to see Spain until the semifinals, or more likely the finals, if Team USA advances that far.
Kobe Bryant, LeBron James, Deron Williams, Tyson Chandler, and Kevin Durant, the NBA scoring champion, the starting five tonight for USA basketball. Little Britain coming off a very impressive win, a victory against Portugal in their last game, and we are underway.
Did you hear that Rocky music in the background? They can get four out wide. See, Carmelo's hanging in the post area. See, he's better out there in pick and roll.
Chris Paul.
That's it. See that?
Just as called, LeBron with a sweet finish. Great ball movement by the United
it's
States.
It's much harder to guard Team USA when they put four on the perimeter and keep one inside.
Tapin. Mensah-Bonsu against Carmelo Anthony. Carmelo knocked it away. And here's LeBron. Nice dish to Durant for the slam. Boy, they get to the other end real quick.
Absolutely, and that's why that pressure perimeter defense is going to be so important for Team USA. So important for Team USA because it really initiates their offense in the open court.
They get those hands in the passing lane. Carmelo and LeBron with another slam. 2:12 to go. And Chris Finch calls timeout for Great Britain because of the 6-0 USA run. Outside the Exchange Theater in Manchester. Back with more after this.
Bobby Kremins, who coached his dad, Ronaldo, and Ronaldo out of Orangeburg, South Carolina, after his Appalachian State career, as LeBron finishes, played in Europe, met his wife in Great Britain, and Andrew Lawrence getting a chance to play against the United States. King Street in Charleston. I know you like that area.
Yeah, great historic district. Darren Williams. LeBron, oh my, he brought the heat.
Great Britain showing a little bit of zone, but once again, Team USA not settling for jump shots versus the zone. And
well, Fran, they've got one of the great zone offensive minds. Once again, great ball movement by the United States, and LeBron didn't miss that dunk. You know, Fran, there's a scouting report. There's a perception always out there that if you zone the United States and one now, make it 52-1 since Coach K took over as the head coach in 2006. Several players in double figures for the United States. Looking for their second consecutive Olympic gold medal. 118-78, the final score. Our next USA basketball broadcast is Sunday night at midnight on ESPN2 when the United States men's national team takes on Argentina from Barcelona, Spain. Coming up next, Numbers Never Lie, presented by Lexus. It's been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Kevin Love finally got it going. For Fran Fraschilla and our entire crew, I'm Mark Jones saying goodbye, everybody, and good night from Manchester.